Repair technicians need to conduct multiple inspections to determine the location of the fault when repairing precision devices like phones, tablets, etc. Repair ideas are particularly important to save time and minimize devices' damage. Today, Raywell Lab shares a repairing case of an iPad Pro not charging. The iPad does not respond to the charging cable after it has been plugged in. In accordance with the principle of simplicity first, complexity later, check the charging port flex cable directly related to the charging function first. Remove the charging port flex cable to inspect it under a microscope. The tail pins have severe wear and tear, and there are two pins are short-circuited. Let's replace the charging port flex cable first and see if that resolves the issue. Connect the Type-C charging cable again. It still cannot charge normally. As a preliminary judgment, the motherboard charging circuit remains defective. Next, check the charging circuit. The PPV bus voltage passes through a resistor to the Type-C charging IC. Connect the iPad with the charging cable, and measure the PPV bus voltage with a multimeter. The voltage is zero. The voltage of PP3V3ACELDO is normal. But the voltage of PP3V3S2ACE cannot be measured, as there will be PPV bus voltage if the Type-C charging IC works properly. So try to replace it with a new Type-C charging IC. Pry off the flex cable and remove the motherboard. To avoid high temperature damage to other components, attach high temperature tape around the Type-C charging IC. Set the hot air gun at 320°C and the speed at 60 to heat. Remove the adhesive around the IC. Heat with hot air gun at 400°C and speed 100. Then use a blade to pry up the IC. Add appropriate amount of paste flux to the pads, and add a bit of medium temperature solder paste. Use soldering iron 380°C to add tin to each pad. Then use solder wick to remove the tin from the bonding pads. Use cotton dipped in PCB cleaner to clean the pads. Heat with a hot air gun at 320°C and speed 60, and use a sculpture knife to remove the remaining adhesive. Drop in a small amount of the paste flux, and continue to remove tin from the pad using a soldering iron and a solder wick. Add a bit of the paste flux to the pad after it has been cleaned. Place a new Type-C charging IC in the correct position. Use the hot air gun at 350° and speed 80 to solder the new IC. Use a multimeter to measure the voltage on the charging line. The voltage was still abnormal. The Type-C charging function also includes an ACE flash ROM in conjunction with the Type-C charging IC. Its damage will result in the loss of stored charging data, which will result in the inability to charge the iPad. Next, replace an ACE flash ROM with written information. Note that any disassembly ACE flash ROM of the same model can be used, and does not need to be bound to the Type-C charging IC. The circuit voltage is detected and the value is normal. The iPad can be charged normally. Regarding the case of iPad not charging, that's all for today. Please feel free to leave your comment.